Hello and welcome to Facebook Best Practices. This is going to be the third video in a series of just helping your Facebook page be more active, received better, and of course how to get more traffic to your website ultimately. But one of the things that we get a lot of folks asking us about is how can I get more likes to my page? Now, a business page in itself doesn't just magically accumulate likes. And Facebook, just like Google, has developed a process whereby they want you to pay to send people to your particular post. That's where AdWords comes in for Google. They've upped the stakes with their new guidelines for 2015 and 16 so that you're not forced to, but encouraged to use Google AdWords to direct traffic to your site. Facebook's no different. They want you to boost the posts so that it'll supposedly get more traffic to your website. But the better way is to do it organically, and you can pretty much achieve the same results depending on how local of a market that you're wanting to get versus a national market. So here's some of the best practices that we've seen. Number one is to have a call to action. Keep in mind that you only have these 68 people for this particular page as your sphere of influence. So out of 68 people, if you put on there, hey guys, we're doing something today, well, only 68 people are going to see it. And the only way to get additional people to like your page is to encourage those 68 people to share the page, to get it out to their circle of friends so that you get more people following your particular page. So that's why having nice, good, relevant content is going to help you with that. Again, Facebook just doesn't arbitrarily send traffic to you. Okay, now they'll make suggested posts, but you've got to be a really, really popular page for Facebook to be able to just make you a suggested post. Okay, so that's very important to keep in mind. If your page is not very popular, you're just not going to get a lot of traffic organically. You have to go outside of that. So you've got to give an encouragement for your 68, in this particular case, followers to share, and if they share, they're going to share it so that everybody else can see it, and that's the trick. If you can get those people to like or share a post, then it will show up on their wall that they have shared it. If it shows up on their wall, then all of their friends in their circle of influence will see it, and if they like it and share it, and so on. So here's some examples of some sites or pages that are doing something like that. This is one, Rough Country Rustic Furniture and Decor. You can, of course, like the page, but win a free Second Amendment Deluxe Home Defense Concealment Flag that features dual handgun and rifle storage. Blah, blah, blah. Like, share and comment below to double your chances. So people that see this and it catches their attention and they read that and see that it's win a free, they're going to go, okay, I'm going to like and share that. So here we've got 6.6 thousand shares that they have expanded their circle of influence by over 6,000 people. Okay, and that's how easy that is in that particular tent. But they're not going to necessarily share this if it's not an advantage for them to do so. And so they're going to be registered, and you can put that in there, register for a free fill in the blank, whatever product or service that your particular company offers, especially something that has a very low cost to it. Let's say if you're a sign company, offer a box of business cards, or a printing company, a box of business cards, a sign company, a free banner, a web company, a free website. I mean, just something that has some tangible value to it. Now, if you're doing, get a free kazoo, well, I'm not going to waste my time over something that's only a dollar or two giveaway. Make it worth something. Okay? You say, well, what's that going to do? Well, here's where the next part of this comes in. This particular one, get over here, has order now, and then it has the actual domain or linked page within the actual content. And then it's got a little thing, tag your friends here, don't forget to like and share. But this isn't a giveaway. This is just offering the product that they offer. And because it's an engaging product that's already something that would be attention-grabbing, you know, don't necessarily have to do a call to action. But if you combine these two mindsets together, what you would do is actually create your contest and then put on there the actual domain for more information or to register online, click here or go to this particular page and paste the URL in, you see? So that's going to do two things. Number one, it's going to expand the influence that you have because you're going to get your friends or those that have liked the page to share this information for you without having to pay. And then the second thing is that if there's something on there that challenges them to go to the website to either complete the registration process, there you can have a contact form or a registration form put on your website, super simple, quick and to the point, but something that will help do two things there, and that's number one, get them to like your page. Because if you can get them to like your page, that takes you from, for example, with this page, 68 people might jump you up to 250, 300, 400, 500, 600 people, which increases your sphere of influence. And if you relate back to the last video, the number of people reached, okay? So you're going from, you know, posting a picture that only got 23 or 24 people to you post a picture and let's say 35 to 40 or 50% of the people were reached and you've got 800 people that have liked your page. Well, that's 400 people that increases the sphere of influence that you have. Now here's another example of a page that is giving a challenge, a simple graphic, okay, Labor Day sale, and at the top, click on that particular URL that takes you to there. It gives you a code for an additional 15%. While this doesn't offer a challenge to like and share, it's still got 12 shares. Okay, which is kind of small for this being a rather large Facebook page. If they would have put on there, you know, get a bumper sticker for liking and sharing or something, it would at least given them some way to compel them. But you can see by adding text and a eye-grabbing picture or an attention-grabbing picture, you can put a special offer in there that, again, will not only help bring traffic to the website, but if you combine these three examples together and put a contest with like and share, relate it to a website with an eye-catching graphic, and then have it have some type of discount code for additional products, you can either do one of these at a time or a combination of all three. Now, if you want to stay within the Facebook realm, we recommend to put a call to action in there that you're giving away something for nothing, and all they got to do is like your page and share. And then it's super easy for you as the page owner for you to just say, okay, let's do this honest and relevant. I'm going to pick a number between 1 and 600 people that liked my page because of this ad. And I'm going to pick number 128. And then you just count down to or copy them over to Excel and grab line 128 if you don't want to count. But, you know, find number 128 that you randomly picked. And then the next thing is the really cool thing. You're going to make a big deal about the person that won. You're going to write a blog article about it. If it's a business association, in other words, let's say you are that sign company that gave away the free banner, you're going to highlight Bob's Plumbing. You know, Bob's Plumbing won the contest. They're on Facebook, blah, blah, blah. And what that's going to do is the next time this goes out, the people that see that again also saw the fact that Bob the Plumber won the banner, and they're like, hey, so this is legit. And so they're going to be more likely to like and share again. And even if they've already liked your page, they can still share the post and still qualify. Do you see? So the more you show the people that you have exposure to, the fact that your giveaway is legitimate, and of course you're going to get the benefit of that, of driven traffic back to your website. But they're going to be more likely to continue to share that and like your page and expand your circle of influence. And the larger the circle of influence you have, the greater means of external traffic that you have going back to your website, which both Facebook and Google can measure that in their statistics. And of course, it goes towards your total quality score. So that's a quick little overview of some ideas to help get your message out in part three. The next tutorial that we'll be going through is even some better best practices to hone in specifically on your message. So make sure you keep tuned for that.